Hey guys! In my cool tricks about the GIMP interface, I used this blue weavy background. And a lot of you wanted to know how I made this, so I figured out how I did it. And I'm gonna teach you how to do this. And this is a blue metallic wavy background with letters and a cat shape. I'm gonna tell you how to do the cat shape as well. That looks like the blue paint has been stripped up. So the first thing you need to do is create a new file. File new, and for the image size it's just best to take your own desktop size background, and for me that's this, and I'm gonna click OK. And now I've got a new file, a white file, and the first thing we're gonna do is go to filters, artistic and weave, and use the following settings: ribbon width 60, ribbon spacing 20, and leave the rest at default and click OK. And now just wait till it's done. And here we've created our weavy base image. And now we're going to create a new layer by clicking on this icon here. And we're going to call it blur. And just because it needs a name. And now make your foreground color white. Go to your bucket fill tool and just fill this in with white. And the next thing we're going to do is go to filters. Oops. Go to filters. Noise. RGB noise. And we're going to use the following settings: red 0.33 and green and blue 2. And you can do this by unticking independent RGB. And then click OK. And now go to colors, desaturate, and make sure lightness is ticked and click OK. And now go to filters, blur, motion blur. And use the following settings: linear, and the length set it at about 114 and put the angle at 0 and click OK. And now it's motion blurring. And after that's done, go to your layer dialog, and on the blur layer set the mode in here in your layer dialog, set the mode to burn. And now go to this duplicate layer icon and click on it twice to make this all a little bit darker. And now right click on the top layer in your layer dialog and click on merge visible layers and click merge. And now we've got our background layer. And now I'm going to create the blue background color, and we're going to do this by creating a new layer and going to call this blue, and make your foreground color, surprisingly, this color yellow, and it's EFEC 01, and click OK, and go to your bucket fill tool and fill this layer in with the color yellow. Now go to your layer dialog, make sure you're on your blue layer, and set the mode to subtract. And there we've got the blue color, but it's way too bright, so we're gonna lower the opacity to about 57.6 is fine. And now we're going to create the text, and go to your text tool here and set your foreground color to black, and use any font you like, anything will be fine. And I'm just going to type in GIMP tricks and put it about here. This is fine. And I'm going to close this one, and then in my layer dialog on my text layer I'm going to set the mode to saturation. And this shows you how to make this stripped off paint effect. Because now it looks like the paint of the letters has been stripped off. The blue paint is gone. And I told you I was going to tell you how to do this with anything else but text. And you can easily do this with something like a brush as well. So I chose this black cat brush. And make sure your foreground color is still on black, and then create a new layer. And I'm going to call this cat. And click OK, and then just go to your paintbrush tool, and what I'm going to do with this cat is just click once where I want the cat to be. And this doesn't look very good, but when I do the same thing again and make sure I'm on my cat layer and go to my layers dialog and do the same thing again, set the mode to saturation, it looks like the paint has been stripped off where the cat is. So that's basically all there is to it. And I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and if you did, then maybe you'd like to watch my other videos and subscribe, and thank you for watching!